got two things here. I've got two things here. One is we continue with what we were doing. हम लोग जो level 2 का continue कर रहे थे, we were talking about magic, sorcery, and nusra and rukya and things like that. Should I continue? And in today's chapter, we can have belief in omens, and we can have astrology की और details. So, do you want me to continue that? Or you want me to take a brief on level 1, which is Aqidah Tawhid ka, what we had done, the basics. Because I had promised that in level 2, we will be doing the revision of Aqidah level 1 also. So I've got something wherein we can quickly rush through the level 1 Aqidah, the basics, and a few questions here and there. And then, inshallah, in a couple of sessions, we will complete this revision. And उसके बाद वी विल कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर्स. व्हाट डू यू सजेस्ट? व्हाट डू यू वांट? यू वांट द रिवीजन और द टॉपिक्स? जस्ट टाइप इट इफ पीपल हु आर नॉट अनम्यूटिंग. जी बोलें.
बोल
व्हाट समस्या
रिपोर्ट? आई डिडंट रिमेंबर टू टर्न इट. लेट मी टर्न पेज.
यस गाइस, प्लीज आंसर मी. तो अकॉर्डिंगली मैं उसके हिसाब से करूंगी रिवीजन. ओके. He has replied revision. Yes, Sarah, what is your opinion?
Revision?
Yeah, okay, new chapters continue kare.
Saying we can go with the revision.
Go with the revision. Any more? I mean, thode aur aate opinion, yeah, I will continue with the revision then. But iske andar phir jinhone attend kiya hai the first wala chapter, they should be able to reply, huh? I mean, it'll be in a form of a quiz and questions, because I'm not going to refer to any of the Quranic verses and hadith. We have already covered that. Main sirf main points pe aate jaungi. So I want you all to reply. So become little active. Thoda sa brush up karenge, inshallah. Okay, let's begin. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. The first level, the Islamic creed, the Islamic religion. When I say the Islamic, the linguistic word, Arabic word, which means submission and obedience, okay, it is called al-istislam, is acceptance of Allah's command. So acceptance comes with obedience, which is al-inqiyad, meaning putting Allah's commands into practice. So there are two things here. Submission and obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal brings peace. That is salam. That is why Islam also means a person who accepts the Islamic way of life and acts upon it. And the one who does this is called Muslim. Okay. So two things that you have to remember here is submission and obedience. That's it. So Islam basically is submission and obedience. And it's not only accepting, but putting into practice. That is more important. Now, Ad-Din al-Islami is the religion that Allah Azza wa Jal has sent to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who is the seal of the messengers. And our deen is complete and the final deen. So no changes and no additions and submissions or omissions can happen. Ye final, full and final hai. और इसी दीन के ऊपर हमारा कंप्लीट फेथ और हमारे कंप्लीट कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट बेस्ड होंगे. सो दैट इज अबाउट अवर इस्लाम. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अकीदा? जब हमने स्टार्ट में बिगिन किया था, आई वाज आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन टू यू गाइस, लाइक व्हाट डज इट मीन. एंड जनरली भी बिफोर टेकिंग अप दिस कोर्स, आई वाज आस्किंग पीपल के उनकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अकीदा क्या है. एंड मेनी पीपल हैव नो आइडिया एज टू व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डज इट मीन. So again, the word aqidah is derived from al-aqad, which is to tie something. Yani to tie something or a knot. It is a knot. How it is connected? Because I tied my heart and mind to it. Al-aqidah is what a person takes as a religion. Yani agar religion ko ek simple usme mujhe explain karna pade aapko, ke if religion is pizza, aqidah is the base of it. Okay, so what toppings you add over it is based on the base. Agar base weak raha to aapka pizza nahi kehlayega. Usi tarike se agar aapka aqida right nahi raha, faith aapka perfect nahi raha, to aap uske upar kitne bhi amal dal dein, it will not fetch you the results. And the sharia definition of aqida is, it is the belief in Allah, his angels, his books, his messengers, the last day, and the belief in qadar. It's good and it's evil. These are also called the pillars of Iman. So basically, Aqeedah in Sharia is equal to Iman. And Aqeedah in terms of literal meaning means tie something firmly, a knot. That is a meaning. So just yani, remember it. Baki kuch itna tension lene ki zarurat nahi hai. I will ask you a true or false now. You can unmute yourself. Islam means peace. True or false?
True.
Awaaz nahi aa rahi. Arshia, thoda loud karein, please.
True.
Okay. The Islamic religion was sent to Prophet Musa alayhi salam. True or false? Baki sare bhi reply kare. I don't want it to be just one-sided. Sare participate kare. It's quite simple, please. It helps me to understand how is your understanding.
True.
Who said true? Prophet. Islamic religion was sent to Prophet Musa alayhi salam.
False.
Okay. To whom was it sent upon? Kaun se nabi pe aaya tha?
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam.
Can you deny more than two of the six pillars of Islam and still be a believer? Yani, six pillars of Islam hai, right?
Yes. You cannot.
You can't. You cannot. Yeah. And you have to believe in all the pillars of Islam, of Iman. You have to believe. If you deny, you cannot stay a believer. To believe in Allah, you should believe in His existence, Lordship, and names and attributes only. True or false?
True.
Not all. True. Yeah. Nee.
Kisi ki kuch aur? No, all.
All. Okay. The Islam is Arabic word, which means dash and dash.
Submission
and peace and submission.
Wrong. One word is correct, second is wrong.
Submission and obedience.
Submission and obedience. Excellent.
Okay.
All right. So that's our Aqeedah. Now, belief in Allah comprises in four matters. Belief in existence of Allah, belief in Allah's lordship, belief in Allah's godhood, and belief in Allah's names and attributes. Let me explain, don't get confused. The belief in the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal. The evidence for the existence of Allah is established by proof of fitrah, which is the human nature. Yani human nature ke andar jo fitrah hai, you can feel that. Proof of mind, which is called al-aql, the reasoning and analysis. Proof of al-shara, which is revealed in the books. And proof of al-his, which is the physical evidence. So, through all these four elements, we can find the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal. What is the proof of fitrah? Every creature has been created in a state of belief in his creator without preceding thought or education. I mean, there are a lot of verses in Quran that speaks about fitra. A human is born on his fitra. So it is jisko hum log normal sense mein by default setting kehte hai na. Like jab hamari roohein alam al-arwa mein, you know how many stages we have passed through and now we are in our living state, right? तो पहले जब हमारी रूहें आलम अल अरवा में थी तब वहां पर एक हमारे साथ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हुआ था एंड वी ऑल अग्रीड टू बी वेरी फेथफुल टू अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल एंड टू बी ओबीडियंट टू हिम एंड टू बी कीप आवरसेल्व्स अवे फ्रॉम शिर्क. तो दैट इज द टाइम व्हेन अवर सोल्स हैड अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विद अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल. सो इट इज इन अवर फितरा. इवन इफ अ चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न इन एनी फैमिली एनी कम्युनिटी, दे आर बॉर्न ऑन देयर फितरा, यानी वो उसका जो प्योर फॉर्म है, they are born Muslims. And that is the reason hum log kabhi jab koi apna religion Islam ki taraf palat kar aata hai to usko hum convert nahi kehte, hum usko revert kehte hain. Revert isliye kehte hain kyunki he was born on the religion of Islam. Phir uske baad uske jo parents ya jo jis mahol mein wo paida hua wo usme convert ho gaya. And if he comes back to religion of Islam, then they have reverted back. So a person is born Muslim. pure and innocent. And then he takes up the religion of his parents, of his teachers, of wherever he has groomed up. So it is about fitra. A sound fitra will appear at times of calamities, disasters, and tragedies when one feels the helplessness and loses the ways of survival. And that's about your default setting. What about the proof of al-aql, where we have the reasoning and the analysis? Yani, where we start seeing and observing and start using our intellectual. And if you look around, when you see the sun, the moon, the stars, ek pura nizam jo chal raha hai. When you look around, you find the changing seasons, you find out that somebody is controlling. Even though bade se bade sciencedan hone do, bade se bade scientists or researchers karne do, unki end result jo hoti hai, even now if you see current situation hamari, itni high technology hone ke bawajood people are unable to control and find an antidote and do something about it. Somewhere down the line, all researchers or scientists, everybody will believe in one supreme power. And that supreme power is of Allah Azza wa Jal. So our reasoning and our analysis also concludes one thing, that the original creator is only one and he is responsible for the running of this universe and its functioning. And it has been mentioned again in many places in Quran. The proof of Ashara, which is the messengers and the messages. It all talks about the laws and instruction that has been revealed in the scriptures. Yani pichli bhi aap scriptures padh le ya the final one, which is the Quran, the final revelation. It all talks about again the same message, the same supreme power, which belongs only to Allah Azza wa Jal. And the fourth is the proof of al-his, which is the physical evidence. It can be illustrated in two ways. First is response to supplication. Yani Allah responds to your dua. We often see and hear the response to those who invoke and call upon Allah for help. And the second is mu'ajizat, the miracles. The miracles that we have heard and read. Some of the examples of the prophets. Jaise Musa alayhi salam ko jo miracles Allah azza wa jal ne diye the, Isa alayhi salam ko diye the, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ko jo miracles diye the. So these are the things through which we can understand and realize and feel the existence of Allah azza wa jal. And we can feel it with everything, right from when the child is conceived in the womb of a mother, the creation, who is providing everything. So with all the things around us, when we see, when we contemplate, jab hum us pe tadabbur karte hain, then you come to know that who is the final creator. So the main point of learning aqeedah is to develop tawheed. Now, what is tawheed? Tawheed is monotheism, believing in the one and only Allah. Agar ek word mein tawheed ko explain karo literally, it is unification, making something one and unique. Okay, it comes from the Arabic word wahda, which means to unite or unify. And what is the Sharia definition of tawheed? It is making of Allah the only one and making him unique in his lordship, in his worship, in his names and attributes. So tawheed ko develop karna, tawheed ko complete karna, tawheed ko perfect karna, ye hai hamara goal, to learn aqeedah. Okay, monotheism, tawheed, unification, making something one and unique. So what are the words of tawheed? La ilaha illallah. There is no true God except Allah. And what? There are many verses from Quran and lot of hadith in this regard. Jisme hume pata chalta hai ki what is the importance of tawheed? And what are the virtues of tawheed? Actually, it is a pillar upon which Islam and all acts of worship are built. It is the noblest branch of knowledge. And because all human beings and jinn are created to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. So why it is important? It is really very important because aapka jo purpose of existence hai, it is based on tawheed. Then again, your worship ki jo essence hai, aapki ibadah ki jo essence or ruh hai, it is based on tawheed. And what are the actions of tawheed? The outer and inner actions. Actions or sayings that are shown to others by being pronounced loudly or done in public, such as the two testimonies of faith, shahadatain. Shahadatain is what? La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. It's two, right? There are two testimonies there. That one is that you are taking only Allah Azza wa Jal. You are affirming that Allah Azza wa Jal is the only God and you are rejecting the other gods. And the second is that you are accepting that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the messenger and slave of Allah Azza wa Jal. So that's your shahadatin, which is your vocal pronunciation. And the prayer and the zakah, hajj, reciting Quran, jihad, slaughtering of animals, swearing oaths or uttering remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. These are your outer actions of tawheed. What is your inner action? It is saying or thoughts that none except Allah Azza wa Jal can know. The one which is hidden, it is not apparent, it is hidden. It is a matter of heart, okay? Such as faith, intentions, vows, trust in Allah, fasting, fear of Allah, hope in Allah, and other such emotions. All these actions and sayings and what Allah Azza wa Jal and His Prophet permitted or prohibited for us to do are acts of worship that should only be done for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, ibadah ki jo hum logon ne do ruling padi thi. What is it that is required when we are doing any sort of ibadah, whether it is hidden or apparent, inner or outer? Two conditions for ibadah. One is ikhlas, done only for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Second is on the way of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Whatever he has commanded to us, guided us, informed us, instructed us, following only that path. And whatever he has stopped us from doing, forbidden act for us, we have to abstain ourselves from that. That we control ourselves not to do what he asked us not to do and to do what he asked us to do. As simple as that. Jab tak ye do conditions fulfill hoti rahengi, tab tak aapki ibadah will be accepted, inshallah. And if these two conditions are not met, then it will be rejected. Plain and clear. Coming to Tawheed al-Rububiyah, the belief in Allah's Lordship. What is Tawheed al-Rububiyah? I want you all to understand this clearly and carefully because isi ke upar mujhe bahut sare sawalat aaye the. Kahin na kahin jaake confusion tha. Rububiyah, Uluhiyah, Asma-ul-Sifat is still very simple. But between the two, Rububiyah and Uluhiyah, there was some confusion. So just listen carefully. Tawheed al-Rububiyah is to single out Allah Azza wa Jal in His actions, creation, ownership and organizing the affairs of the creation. Means Rab ki jo mani hai, Rab ki jo wazaat hai, wo hai Khalik, Malik, Mudabbir. Khalik is the creator, Malik is the owner, Mudabbir is the manager who manages the affairs. Alhamdulillah, excuse me. So, Rab, Khalik, Malik, Mudabbir. Remember that. खालिक से आपको क्रिएशन का समझ आ जाएगी, ही इज द क्रिएटर, ओनरशिप समझ आ जाएगी, एंड मुदब्बिर से ऑर्गेनाइजिंग समझ आ जाएगी. सो अल्लाह इज द ओनली लॉर्ड, ओनली रब, हु क्रिएट्स, ओन्स एंड कमांड्स एवरीथिंग इन द यूनिवर्स विदाउट एनी पार्टनर और सपोर्टर. ठीक है, दैट इज योर रुबूबिया. सो एवरीथिंग दैट हैपेंस, इट हैपेंस थ्रू अल्लाहस नॉलेज, हिज विल एंड हिज पावर. Belief in Allah Azza wa Jal includes the belief that nothing takes place in the universe without His permission. यानी एक पत्ता भी अगर जो गिरता है वो अल्लाह की मर्जी से, permission से गिरता है. No good can be obtained nor harm avoided unless Allah decrees it. यानी जो भी हमारे साथ हो रहा है, अच्छा, बुरा, good, evil, anything and everything, वो सब कुछ अल्लाह की knowledge से ही हो रहा है. And Allah की final will है इसमें. Consequently, good luck charms and amulets, good and evil omens, etc., are all false. Yani, isme kisi bhi manghadat belief ka, isme taviz, koi charm, koi stone, kisi shay ka koi lena dena nahi hai. Okay. Examples of those who deny Allah's rububiyyah are example. Humne ek community ka naam liya tha, ek belief system jinka hai, wo hai al dahniyun. ये वो है, those who claim that time is their lord. इनकी belief ये है कि time जो है वो इनका रब है. Time will make them die. Old age is the cause of death. तो ये incorrect beliefs हैं, but I just thought I'll mention. Don't worry about that. So that is about Tawheed al-Rububiyah. Coming to Tawheed al-Uluhiya. The belief in Allah, Allah's Godhood. What is it? It is to single out Allah alone in worship. Ye baat aap samjhe? Uluhiya is related to worship and Rububiya is related to the Lordship. So, you are singling out Allah Azzawajal for all sorts of worship. Har ibadah aapki Allah Azzawajal ko direct karenge aap. Tawheed al-Uluhiya is the key and essence of the call of the messengers. Yani sare nabi, sare rasul ek hi message, ek hi baat ko lekar pura time preach karte rahe. Aur wo tha Tawheed. And specially Tawheed al-Uluhiya. Because it is the foundation upon which all the actions are built. It is also known as Tawheed al-Ibadah. Because it is related to the worship. So, Tawheed al-Uluhiya is equal to Tawheed al-Ibadah. Allah Azza wa Jal is the only one who deserves our worship. Like prayer, zakah, fasting, hajj, jihad. We should ask help only from Allah Azza wa Jal and we should only fear Him. Yani hamara jo basic emotions maine aapse pehle bhi discuss kiya tha. Love, hope and fear. Love is muhabba, hope is raja, fear is khauf. Ye sare emotions jo hai hamare kiske liye? It is directed to Allah Azza wa Jal. We should love Him, fear Him, be hopeful of Him. We should make our vows only to Him and have full trust in Him. All our matters and worship should be directed to Allah alone. This is the type of tawheed that all messengers of Allah called for. So, real believers or disbelievers mein yahi farak hona hai. Believers ye sari cheezon mein faith rakhta hai. Aur disbeliever isko deny karta hai. Aur isi wajah se they deserve to be punished. The effect of tawheed al-rububiyya and tawheed al-uluhiyya. He who declares Tawheed al-Rububiyya and affirms that there is no creator, provider or administrator of the universe except Allah, then he is required to proclaim that none deserves all forms of worship except Allah, which is known as Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. Tawheed al-Rububiyya is a proof of Tawheed al-Uluhiyya and this is why Allah has mainly used Tawheed al-Rububiyya, a proof against the deniers of Tawheed. There are some जो के तौहीद और रुबूबिया में बिलीव करते हैं बट तौहीद अल उलूहिया में नहीं बिलीव करते यानी वो एक्सेप्ट करते हैं कि अल्लाह अलोन इज द रब बट वर्शिप जो है वो सिर्फ अल्लाह को सिंगल आउट नहीं करते वो जो है और माबूदों की भी पूजा करते हैं सो दैट इज वेयर दे गो रॉन्ग एंड दैट इज अगेन एन इनकम्प्लीट एंड इम्परफेक्ट फेथ बिकॉज टू कम्प्लीट द फेथ देयर हैज टू बी एन अफर्मेशन एंड निगेशन अगर आप द वर्ड्स ऑफ शहादा को भी ले तो इट बिगिंस विद निगेशन इट बिगिंस विद ला इलाहा यानी यू हैव टू रिजेक्ट द अदर गॉड्स जब तक आपका दूसरे गॉड्स को रिजेक्शन नहीं होगा आपका अफर्मेशन ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल कंप्लीट नहीं होगा सो तौहीद अरुबूबिया इज अ प्रूफ ऑफ तौहीद अल उलूहिया एंड दैट इज व्हाई इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी बिलीव इन दिस टू स्पेशली द उलूहिया Thus he ordered them with Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, which is his worship and presented as a proof. Tawheed al-Rububiyya, which is that he created the people of the earlier times and later. So it is not befitting for them to associate partners with Allah, whom they know that they have not done any of the above or anything else besides that. Clear Tawheed al-Rububiyya and Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. If any questions, you may ask now. Ya phir hum aage phir asma wa sifat pe continue karenge. क्लियर है बिल्कुल आई विल बी आस्किंग क्वेश्चन ऑलराइट फॉरवर्डिंग टू तौहीद अल अस्मा व सिफत तौहीद अल अस्मा व सिफत इज टू बिलीव इन एवरी नेम एंड एट्रीब्यूट्स दैट अल्लाह अफर्म्ड फॉर हिमसेल्फ और दोज दैट इज मैसेंजर मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम अफर्म्ड फॉर हिम यानी वो सारे नाम जो अल्लाह ताला ने हमको कुरान में रिवील किए हैं या मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने हमें बताया वो सारे नामों की कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स और सिफत जो है उसमें बिलीव करना दिस इज टू बिलीव दैट अल्लाह हैज द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल नेम्स एंड ही डिस्क्राइब्ड हिमसेल्फ बाय द मोस्ट परफेक्ट डिस्क्रिप्शंस इन हिज बुक एंड इन द ट्रेडिशंस ऑफ द सुन्ना अ मुस्लिम शुड बिलीव इन ऑल दिस नेम्स एंड एट्रीब्यूट्स विदाउट डिस्टॉर्शन विदाउट निगेशन और रिजेक्शन विदाउट डिस्क्राइबिंग और सेइंग हाउ एंड विदाउट मेकिंग सिमिलैरिटीज यानी आपका बेसिक फेथ ऑन इन द नेम्स एंड एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ोजल ऐसा होना चाहिए कि आप उसको खराब डिस्टॉर्ट नहीं कर सकते. ओके, आप उसको रिजेक्ट नहीं कर सकते. आप ये क्वेश्चन नहीं कर सकते कि ये कैसे, और आप उसमें कोई सिमिलैरिटीज नहीं कर सकते. दैट इज योर एक्शन टुवर्ड्स द अस्मा व सिफात. वी शुड हैव फेथ इन दिस नेम्स बिकॉज दे हैव बीन मेंशनड बाय अल्लाह अज़्ज़ोजल इन द कुरान, एंड वी हैव टू बिलीव इन दैट पावर. इवन दो हमारे ह्यूमन माइंड के लिए टू अंडरस्टैंड और to contemplate it might be difficult, but you should have complete faith in them. The effect of believing in tawheed of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal and his attributes is to getting to know Allah Azza wa Jal better. Jab aap Allah ki asma aur sifat aap padhte hain with the detailed explanation, aapke andar ek bahut zyada faith jo hai strong ho jata hai. Because when you realize that your Lord, your Rabb is so powerful, is so graceful, is so merciful, then you feel very secure. आपके अंदर एक अलग सी confidence आती है, आपके अंदर वो fear आता है, आपके अंदर वो love, यानी वो सारे emotions जो हैं आपके, वो ज़्यादा multiply हो जाते हैं. और इस knowledge से क्या होता है कि आपका faith भी strong होता है. So those who know and understand Allah's names and attributes are bound to have their hearts filled with awe of Him and love for Him. And tend to submit to him alone. अभी एक बात आप ज़हन में रखें, हमें अल्लाह की पहचान नहीं होती है, इस वजह से हम we continue sinning, we continue being disobedient. लेकिन एक बार जब आपको इस चीज़ का एहसास हो जाए कि my Lord is recording every single act, is recording every single word, is even aware of what is deep down inside my heart. यानी मेरे दिल के अंदर जो hidden matters हैं, मेरी नियत क्या है, मेरा अंदर का मामला क्या है, वो भी अल्लाह ताला को पता है. तो हाउ विल बी योर एक्शंस इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड कि आपके सर के ऊपर एक सीसीटीवी लगा हुआ है जो कंटिन्यूसली आपको फॉलो कर रहा है, तो आपके एक्शंस कितने रिफाइंड होंगे. आई डोंट थिंक सो यू विल बी स्क्रैचिंग हियर एंड देयर एंड पिकिंग अप द गोल्ड फ्रॉम द माइन. नो, यू विल नॉट बी डूइंग एनीथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट. आपके बहुत एक्शंस रिफाइंड हो जाएंगे. उसी तरीके से हम लोगों को इस चीज का एहसास होना चाहिए. Every time, whenever we are about to sin, akele mein ya sabke samne, khalwat ya jalwat, you should be aware and conscious of this fact that somebody is watching you, somebody is recording you, somebody is aware, and we are answerable. Hum aakhir mein accountable hain. To ye cheezon ke baare mein agar consciousness hogi, if your heart is alive, then you will not sin. So what do we do is we understand better, we understand, we are able to comprehend the powers and the attributes by learning about his names. And secondly, we are praising Allah by using his beautiful names. Yani in dua, whenever we are invoking, it is preferred that we use those names and we ask Allah and make invocations. Hum dua kare Allah ke beautiful names jo mention kiye gaye hain, and based on the situation, जैसे अगर हम बीमार के लिए दुआ कर रहे हैं तो हम शिफा वाले अल्लाह के नामों का इस्तेमाल करें कि यू आर द शाफी. हमें अगर प्रोटेक्शन चाहिए तो हम उस तरीके से हिफाजत वाली, यानी उस सिफत के मुताबिक हम वो जो नाम है अल्लाह के, या सीकिंग फॉरगिवनेस तो या गफूर रहीम. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सिचुएशन एंड वॉट वी आर सीकिंग, वी कैन यूज दोज ब्यूटिफुल नेम्स. इट इज प्रिफर टू यूज दोज नेम्स. एंड दैट्स अबाउट the three kinds of tawheed: tawheed al-rububiyyah, tawheed al-uluhiyyah, and tawheed wa asma wa sifat. The two testimonies talking about shahadatain now: la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. There is no true God except Allah Azza wa Jal, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. The Arabic word ilah, God, refers to any being that is worshipped. Yani koi bhi shay jo jiski ibadat hoti hai, उसको इलाह कहते हैं अरबिक में. Thus, whoever worships something has in fact taken it as a god beside or instead of Allah. All such deities are indeed false, except for the true God, Allah Azza wa Jal. What is the virtue of La ilaha illallah? Whoever says La ilaha illallah sincerely from the heart will enter paradise. Those who sincerely worship Allah following the dictates of the testimony of the faith will certainly lead a happy life, for it is only by worshipping Allah alone that the heart finds peace and real satisfaction. Yani hum sab ki kya talash hoti hai, hum sab ki talash hoti hai sakina, which is peace and tranquility. Hamara jo ek soul hai wo mutmain rahe, hum peaceful rahe. And I'm not talking about the materialistic and the financial gains. Trust me, that doesn't give you the ultimate happiness. What is the state of ultimate happiness is that state of mutmainna. It is mentioned in the Quran as well. And how can one achieve that? The shortcut and the easiest way is to lead a life of believing in La ilaha illallah. Those who truly believes in that, they experience or they taste the sweetness of this peace. The great statement comprises of two parts, which must be known in order to understand its meaning. The first part is La ilaha illallah, that is the negation, the existence of any other deity. Bar bar hum is cheez par stress kar rahe hain kyunki kafi sare log jo hain ye is bare mein unko is cheez ka idea hi nahi hai ki there is not only affirmation but negation as well. Aur yahi wajah hai ki jo hum log dekhte hain jo log bida aur shirk mein mubtila hai, they are affirming but they are not negating. So ye belief aur ye faith hona bahut zaruri hai that you are affirming that la ilaha illallah but you have to negate the other forms of Mabud. So it is two parts, affirmation and negation. So what are the conditions of La ilaha illallah? Knowledge that negates ignorance. Certainty that negates the doubt. Acceptance that negates the rejection. Submission that negates the abandonment. Truthfulness that negates the hypocrisy. Sincerity that negates shirk. And love that negates its opposite, which is hatred. In some places it is 7 conditions, in some places it is 8 condition. The 8th condition is to purify yourself from the shirk. So these are the conditions. We had discussed about this in detail. Again I repeat, knowledge that negates ignorance, certainty that negates doubt, acceptance that negates rejection, submission that negates abandonment, truthfulness that negates hypocrisy, sincerity that negates shirk, love that negates its opposite, which is hatred, and the additional 8th condition is purify yourself from shirk. So what is the meaning of Muhammad is the messenger of Allah azza wa jal, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is to believe firmly that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent by Allah with the message of Islam. यानी मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम का मकसद क्या था, उनको भेजा गया था मैसेज के साथ ताकि वो इस्लाम का मैसेज जो है वो स्प्रेड करे इंसानों में और जिन में. वी हैव टू हैव फेथ इन हिम, ओबे हिम एंड लव हिम. अगेन ये फेथ, लव एंड ओबे का जो कंसेप्ट है उसकी भी एक हुदूद है. अगर आप उस हुदूद को एग्जैजरेट कर जाए देन इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इन टू शिर्क. रिमेंबर दैट शिर्क की इजाद कहाँ से होती है, शिर्क की इजाद एग्जैजरेशन से होती है. जब कभी भी राइट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट हिस्ट्री से हम अगर निकाल लें, नूह अलैहिस्सलाम के टाइम से निकाल लें, तब से लेकर अब तक जब कभी भी इंसान ने किसी नेक और पायस इंसान को ओबीडियंस, लव, अतात में जब हद से ज्यादा तजावुज करने की कोशिश की है तब तब शिर्क की इजाद हुई है. सो इवन इन रिवरिंग अवर मैसेंजर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम, टू हैव फेथ इन हिम, टू ओबे हिम एंड टू लव हिम, देयर इज अ बाउंड्री. उस हुदूद के अंदर ही रहे, उनके कमांडमेंट्स के हिसाब से ही रहे तो बेहतर है. इफ वी एग्जैजरेट और डू थिंग्स दैट ही हैज फॉरबिडन अस टू डू, वन माइट फॉल इनटू शिर्क. All of these are obligations upon all Muslims. We must know that he would not make up any words on his own. Yani Quran, we definitely know, is a revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal. Even Hadith is based on revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never said or did anything from his own will. So, our faith, jo hai, wo dono mein hi equal hai. Aur jo Hadith ko negate karta hai, again, he is not complete in his faith. You have to have belief in both sources, which is Quran and Sunnah. To complete true faith, there are few more things that we must believe in order to fully accept that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah azza wa jal. To have faith in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is obligatory. Yani you cannot say it is an option. Main chahu believe karun nahi karun, nahi. Obligatory. It is a matter of obligatory. The Islam of anyone is not complete until that the person believes in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the messenger of Allah azza wa jal. After believing in Allah, you have to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Obeying him is obligatory. Again, believing that he is the messenger is obligatory. Second is obeying him is obligatory. Third, it is obligatory for us to love him. We have to love him. In fact, there are hadith which says we have to love him more than our money, our children, our parents, ourselves. Until and unless we don't do that, our faith is not complete. We have to believe that he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is free from major sins. All the prophets of Allah were free from major sins because Allah azza wa jal wanted them to be our role models. So he took care that the prophets and the messengers are free from major sins. Then we have to believe that he is the seal of the prophets. He is the final messenger. There will be no messenger after him until the day of judgment. We have to believe that his message is to the whole of humankind and jinn. Yani sirf Muslim community ke liye nahi, the whole of humankind and jinn. Just like Quran. Quran is not meant for only for Muslims, but for the whole of mankind. We have to believe that he has conveyed the message completely. Yani hum se kuch bhi chupa nahi tha. Even if you refer to the last lecture, okay, usme bhi he has confirmed it, that he has communicated everything. Yani choti se choti, badi se badi matter, intimate se intimate matter ko Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne disclose kiya, hamare tak uski knowledge aur information pahunchai. So there is nothing that is hidden. He did his job 100% of completing or conveying the message of Allah Azza wa Jal. To believe that, to have knowledge of his honor and his great status without any exaggeration. Again, what we discussed earlier, that jo galti Yahud aur Nasara ne ki thi, unhone apne messengers ko itna zyada exaggerate kar diya ke wo God ke level tak le gaye. वो मिस्टेक हमने नहीं करनी, ना एग्जैजरेशन ज्यादा, ना उनको डीवैल्यू, नथिंग, इन बैलेंस. व्हाट हैज बीन आस्क्ड एंड प्रिस्क्राइब्ड, डूइंग दैट एंड स्टेइंग इन बैलेंस इज व्हाट आवर रिलीजन इज ऑल अबाउट. सो दैट इज अबाउट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड आवर एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड्स हिम. ओके, ट्रू ऑर फॉल्स? अनम्यूट दोज हु आर अटेम्प्टिंग. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was free of all sins. True or false?
Haan ji? True.
Okay.
True.
All right. True. Learning about tawheed is an individual duty. Fard al-ayn or fard al-kifaya? Is it a communal obligatory ya individual obligatory thing? Learning about tawheed.
Individual, I think.
Individual. I think, nahin, sure.
Yes.
Let me quickly tell you, for those who don't know what is Fard al-Ayn and Fard al-Kifaya, there are certain things, certain obligations that an individual has to do. For example, can I pray Salah on behalf of you? No.
No.
Personal obligation. Mm-hmm. Then there are certain communal obligation. Maslan, the Imam is praying Salatul Janaza. So he's doing things on the behalf of community. And if one person does it, like some person is going for jihad, jihad al-qital. So that one person is doing jihad for the sake of the community. So that is, that will suffice. So there are certain obligations which is communal, and there are certain obligations which is personal. Jo personal hai, wo fard al-ayn hai. So tawhid goes into the category. The knowledge of tawhid goes into the category of fard al-ayn. Yani each individual, it is an obligation that he should know or have the knowledge of tawhid. Okay? So that is your individual obligation. Tawhid is a reason to enter paradise.
Sorry, what's the question?
Pure tawhid is a reason to enter paradise. Yeah.
Fear.
Yeah, answer that. Tricky question.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Pure Tawheed is a reason to enter paradise. Since yes. Yeah. Kuch aur bhi aana chahiye. हाँ जी बोला द रीजन टू पैराडाइज एक बात आप जहन में रखें यस बोल के अकेला ये आंसर कंप्लीट इसलिए नहीं होता क्योंकि टू एंटर पैराडाइज व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज नॉट योर गुड डीड्स नॉट एनीथिंग एल्स बट द विल ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल यानी जब अल्लाह की मर्जी होगी
तो तक्वा इज देयर आल्सो
यस यस बाय द विल ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल ठीक है
ओके
ऑलराइट Now fill in the blanks, huh? Every child is born on dash, but his parents make him a Jew, Christian, or a
Pitra.
Pitra. Okay, very good. Dash has vowed to mislead all the children of Adam alayhi salam. Kisne
Shaitan.
Kisne kasam
khaya? Shaitan.
Okay.
Iblis.
Iblis. Yes. The type of tawheed that all messengers of Allah call for is?
Uluhiyat.
Very good. Dash will be the first to enter paradise. Who will be entering paradise?
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. Very good.
Sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Okay. The fountain of, okay, this is a multiple question, multiple choice question. Huh? The fountain that Allah gave to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in paradise is called?
5 times of prayers.
No.
How is it called?
Fountain, kabhi, foundation. Ne kabhi.
No.
The fountain that Allah azawajal gave to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in paradise is called?
How is it called?
Aqsa al-Kawthar.
Kawthar.
Okay, the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Now I'm giving you the choices, huh? 4 choices. La ilaha illallah is there is no God except Allah. There is no true God except Allah. There is no Lord except Allah. Kaunsa sahi?
First.
Okay. Were the human created by nothing or were they created themselves? Options are Al Fitra, human nature, Al Aql, mind. Or Al Sharia, messengers and messages, and Al Qis, the common sense. What is the answer? ये थोड़ा tough हो गया हाँ. समझ नहीं आया.
Repeat the question, please.
Were the humans created by nothing, or were they created themselves?
By and the choice
actually this is
they were nothing
actually this is in reference to verse in the Quran so mere khayal se aap logon ko isko thoda samajhne ke liye if I give the verse then you can understand but the answer to it is al aql yani through the mind reasoning and analysis ke basis pe hua tha so don't worry about that because we can discuss the Quranic verses na so no problem
okay,
Muslim is a person who believes that the mother nature is his Lord, or a person who accepts the Islamic way of life and acts upon it, a person who says Shahada without believing in his heart, or a person who says Shahada only to benefit from being Muslim. Kaun se 4 options hai? One who believes mother nature, second who learns the Islamic way and acts upon it, third is Shahada without believing, and fourth is Shahada only to benefit the Muslims.
Number two.
The one who accepts the Islamic way and acts upon it. Who denies a rububiya are? Okay, I'll give you the option. Who denies a rububiya are? The arrogant people such as Firaun, the materialistic communist and heretical, al-Dahriyun who claim that time is their Lord. Who denies a rububiya out of the 3? Firaun?
The third one.
No, the Dahiriyun is the one who believes Lord as the time. That's wrong.
Okay.
Rububiya nahi hai, wrong hai.
Second.
Well. ये भी ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन है, थोड़ा ध्यान से।
फर्स्ट
इज फिरौन, सेकंड इज द मटेरियलिस्ट कम्युनिस्ट, थर्ड इज अदाहिल एंड डी इज ऑल ऑफ द अबव।
All of the above
is the correct answer. Because ये सारे जो हैं वो
different example.
तौहीद अल इबादा, तौहीद अल this thing created जो है रब की, उसको deny करते हैं. So वो original, if you go to Quran, I am the Lord. Lordship को deny करते हैं. Materialistic communist का भी यही चक्कर है. And दाहरी जो है वो again lordship को deny करते हैं. All of them. Okay, Allah told the believers to love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should love him more than Allah. We should exaggerate his status over what Allah has given him. It is not obligatory to love his family and companions. We should love his family and companions. Haan ji, answer. Allah told the believers to love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Options are, we should love him more than Allah. Option B, we should exaggerate his status over what Allah has given him. Numbers, obligatory to love his family and companions. And option number D, we should love his family and companions. So what is the correct answer?
We should love his family.
Very good. That's the correct one. We should not exaggerate his status, right? We should not love him more than Allah. And it is not obligatory to love his family and companions. No, we have to love his family and companions. So, inshallah, tomorrow we will go through the types of shirk and the invalidators of Islam, and we'll continue with this revision. Koi question hai, koi discussion hai, kuch to bolein please. We have got another 2-3 minutes there. Jo abhi aaj humne discuss kiya, uske andar koi question hai?
Nahi.
रिविजन बिल्कुल
नहीं, नो क्वेश्चन,
बिल्कुल क्लियर हो गया।
हेलो,
हाँ जी,
हेलो, अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
वालेकुम
अस्सलाम जी। जी, क्योंकि ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह की बात हो रही थी तो एक हदीस याद आ रही है।
बोलो बोलो बोलो।
मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम के, आई नो दैट मेनी ऑफ अस मे बी नोइंग दिस, कि मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम अल्लाह से बातें कर रहे थे कि टीच मी सम वर्ड्स, मुझे कुछ ऐसे कलिमात सिखाओ जिससे मैं तुमको याद कर सकूं, यानी बाय विच आई कैन रिमेम्बर यू। तो अल्लाह ने कहा कि ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह कहो। तो मूसा अलैहि सलाम ने कहा कि ये तो सारे लोग कहते हैं, सभी बंदे कहते हैं, मुझे कुछ स्पेशल सिखाओ। तो कहा कि
ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह कहो।
हेलो,
कंटिन्यू
या तो ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह कहो। तो फिर अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल ने कहा कि क्योंकि ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह अगर एक पैन पे रख दिया जाए और सातों आसमान और जमीन एक पैन पे रख दिया जाए तो ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह आउटवे करेगा इंशाल्लाह।
स्टिल वेटिंग, यस, बिल्कुल सही। एंड जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर फरीन फॉर शेयरिंग दैट ब्यूटीफुल हदीस, एंड दैट इज द पावर ऑफ ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह। और इसके क्योंकि अभी ये रमजान टाइम है, जनरली हमारे जिक्र अस्कार थोड़े से हम ज्यादा कर पा रहे हैं इसमें, तो ये बात भी ज़हन में रखें कि सुबह शाम के अस्कार के साथ आप एक एक 100 की तस्बीह ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह की भी करें, देन सुबहानअल्लाह व बिहम्दिही सुबहानअल्लाह अज़ीमी की भी करें, देन सुबहानअल्लाह अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह अल्लाहू अकबर, ये सुबह शाम थोड़ा थोड़ा सा इसका भी जिक्र करें। एंड रमदान इज द टाइम व्हेन यू कैन प्रैक्टिस एंड इनकल्केट सर्टेन हैबिट्स, यानी जैसे जिसको तहज्जुद की आदत नहीं वो तहज्जुद को पकड़ ले, जिक्र अस्कार कुरान को ज्यादा से ज्यादा अपने साथ ज्वाइन कर ले, तो रमदान में एक अच्छी प्रैक्टिस हो जाती है। सो एनीथिंग दैट यू डू फॉर फ्यू डेज एंड फ्यू वीक्स इट विल बिकम योर हैबिट। सो वन मंथ इज अ गुड इनफ टाइम फॉर अस to learn and inculcate something. तो हमेशा अपनी इबादा में, अपने नॉलेज में हर रोज जो है आपका एक एडिशन होना चाहिए, इजाफा होना चाहिए। That is how you progress and you calculate कि हाँ you are in the right direction. तो may Allah make us among those जो कि अल्लाह के मुकर्रबून में शामिल हो सकें, and our knowledge and our ilm we should be implementing it in our lives and we should be helping our family to achieve that target as well. तो ये सिर्फ अकेले का काम नहीं है कि मैं अकेले जन्नत चली जाऊं, लेकिन अपनी पूरी एंटायर लव्ड वंस और कम्युनिटी को साथ लेकर इंशाल्लाह चलने वाली बात है। तो कोशिश करें कि जितना हो सके अपनी नॉलेज को इंक्रीज करें, अपने सीखी हुई चीजों को अप्लाई कर सकें रोज के हिसाब से। मुसलसल वाली जो नेकियां हैं वो ज्यादा अल्लाह ताला को बिलावड है, आज किए कल भूल गए परसों और अपनी चाल, ऐसा नहीं। डू समथिंग, एक स्मॉल भी है जेस्चर, उसको कंटिन्यूसली आपने करते रहना, ये कोशिश करनी है। और इंशाल्लाह मैं अल्लाह एक्सेप्ट, हमारी छोटी बड़ी जितनी भी कोशिशें हैं उसको अल्लाह ताला एक्सेप्ट करे और हमसे राजी हो जाए, दैट इज अवर फाइनल कोशिश। सो इंशाल्लाह विल मीट टुमारो। सुभानक अल्लाहुम्मा व बिहमदिक अशहदु अल्ला इलाहा इल्ला अंता नस्तगफिरुक व नतूबु इलैक। अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। जज़ाकल्लाह खैर सिस्टर्स।